Hello students, welcome to our online teaching class of Balaji Public School. In the previous class, we will discuss about the first part of children at work, class 8 English. So today we will discuss the second part of the chapter Children at Work, written by Gita Wood. So before we start the second part, just I would like to remind you that where the girl asked Belu to come with her so that she can provide him some food or other things also. At first, Belu could not decide what to do, what he would do then, because he belonged to a rural area. He was not so prompt like the girl. But when the girl left and went away, then suddenly Belu decided to follow her and went out. What happened thereafter, let us see. That has been described in your part second. Belu follows his friend through the crowded streets to a big building. Behind the building, there is a big garbage bin. Belu wonders why they are there at all. He caught up with the girl as she was leaving the station. When they got to the road, Belu found that the vehicles kept coming and never stopped for anyone. Smoke and dust flew at him from all sides, making his head spin. They had to wait for a long time before they could find a gap to run through. Belu kept hesitating, and the girl finally dragged him to the other side. So let us see. Here, caught up with means came along. So Belu caught up with the girl. So in such situation, Belu came along with the girl as she was leaving the station. And when they got to the road, when both Belu and the girl got to the road, Belu found that the vehicles were large numbers of vehicles were coming and going here and there, and they never stopped. For anyone, besides smoke and dust flew at him by which from all sides. The smoke and dust were also flew at him from all sides. By that, his head was spinning. They had to wait for a long time before they could find a gap to run through. They had to wait for a long time. Belu and the girl had to, as they were coming here and there, and they had to cross the road, but they were not getting any chance to cross it because numbers of vehicles were coming and going, and there was no gap to cross the road. And they had to wait for a long time before they could find a gap. Belu kept hesitating, and the girl finally dragged him to the other side. Dragged. Here, dragged means pulled. Dragged means pulled. So here, in such situations, you know that Belu belonged to a rural area, and he did not have so much courage. Also, he was getting very frightening also. Belu kept hesitating in such a situation, and the girl finally dragged him to one side, pulled him to one side, pulled him to the other side. Okay? In such situation, how to, so in this way, with the help of the girl, H was very prompt, guided Venu to cross the road. What do you think you are doing? What do you think you are doing, grazing cows? If you stand around in the middle of the road like that, you will be chutney. What do you think you are doing, grazing cows? So when Venu was looking here and there, different things, perhaps some grazing of cows, gopalas, etc., the girl frequently commenting, was passing different comments on Venu and what she was looking at, what she was gazing at, what he was gazing at, all these things. And finally also passed the comment that if he stands around in the middle of the road like that, then he will be chutney. That means he will be crossed by different vehicles that are coming along the road. Belu's heart was still beating fast. He looked back at Central Station and the traffic speeding by. Belu's heart was still beating fast. His heartbeat was moving more and more. Belu's heart was still beating very fast. He looked back at Central Station and the traffic speeding by. That means his heartbeat was very high and he was comparing the places between the Central Station, that is the railway station, and the place where he is, the traffic place. How had they managed to come through that? Then he was observing that how it became possible on their part to come there. They walked along the side of the road under some huge signboards. So in this way, they were walking along the roads on one side, and they were observing, they were looking different signboards hanging from different buildings, different enterprises, different shops. Here signboards, you know, billboards, yes. Belu looked up at the pictures, banyans, car, tires, pens, a woman holding a box. The writing was all in English, so he did not know what it meant. Belu was looking everything, looking up at the different things which were hanging, different signboards from different shops and buildings. Somewhere to the pictures of banyans, car, tires, pens, a woman holding a box, all these things. The writing was, all the signboards were written in English. And so he did not know what it meant. Okay? So the girl turned onto a wide bridge, and here the girl turned onto a wide bridge and walked up. Belu stopped and peeped over the railing. Under him, the road ran into the city. In the distance, he could see huge buildings and towers and more roads. They reached at a place where the girl turned onto a wide bridge. Thereafter she walked up, and at that time Belu stopped there and peeped over the railing. Peeped means here looked. Peeped over means looked over. So here, peeped over the railing. Railing, you know, iron fence, that is known as the railing. Okay, so in these situations, people and railing, so when the girl went onto a wide bridge and walked. At that time, Belu stopped and looked over the railing. What the girl was doing there? Under him, the road ran into under him because he was standing at a bridge, and under him, the road ran into the city. In the distance, he could see huge buildings and towers. In the distance, he could see large and huge buildings and towers, and more roads were also there. All these things he was looking up. See that big buildings with the wall around it. If you are not careful, you will soon be counting bars there. The girl grinned and pointed at a huge building. Grinned means smiled. Grinned means smiled. See that big building with the wall around it. If you are not careful, you will soon be counting bars there. The girl grinned and pointed at a huge building. Thereafter, when Belu was looking here and there and observing different large buildings here and there, different routes, the routes running to different routes running to the city, and he was getting astonished. Just at that time, the girl joined him and asked him if he looked like this, then he would be counting bars there. The girl smiled at him. The girl made jokes with him and pointed at a huge building. Thereafter, telling like this, he pointed at him a huge building. Belu squinted, matlab. Squinted means screwed his eyes. Belu squinted and read the Tamil sign, Central Jail. Why? I haven't done anything wrong. You don't have to do anything, just don't get caught. That is all. Thereafter, when the girl showed Belu a large building, that is the building of the Central Jail. It has been written in Tamil literature, Tamil language, Tamil Central Jail. Then Belu asked him, "Why I have not done anything wrong?" And Belu told the girl that he had not done anything wrong. So why he will go? Why he would be caught and pushed into the jail? Caught into that cell. What does she mean? Belu wondered. Meanwhile, the girl was already heading down the bridge with the sack on her shoulder. What does she mean? Belu wondered. Meanwhile, the girl was already heading down the bridge with the sack on her shoulder. What was it in? He had seen her putting plastic cups into it at the station. Thereafter, what does she mean? Belu wondered. Belu was totally getting astonished. Meanwhile, the girl was already heading down the bridge with the sack on her shoulder. Having the sack on her shoulder, the girl went under the bridge with the sack on her shoulder. What was in it? He had seen her putting plastic cups into it at the station. Matlab, from the very beginning I had told you, the girl was a rag picker. She was picking up different thrown away plastic cups, bottles, everything into that and was putting all those things into that sack. What are you carrying in that bag? Things, bottle, paper. Belu wondered what she was doing with them, but he felt shy to ask any more questions. And Belu asked in such situation that Belu wanted to know that what she was doing and what to. In reply, the girl told him that she was picking up plastic cups, bottles, etc. And what would, thereafter again, he is asking Belly wondered what she did, but he did not dare, rather he felt, did not dare to ask any more questions, but he felt shy. It was still morning, but the sun blasted down means melted down. It was still morning, but the sun blasted down on the tap and Belu's bare feet burned. Thereafter, it became midday, matlab lunch time, that means midday. It was still morning, but the sun blasted down on the tap. It was getting more and more hot due to the rising of the sun ahead. And Belu was barefooted, so it was burning, his bare feet were burning. It was not like walking on a mud road. He was soaked with sweat, and his body was also sweating. His bare footed was burning. On the one hand, he was also very hungry, as he had not taken any food for the last 2 days, you know it. He tried hard to walk in the shade and keep up with the girl at the same time. He also tried hard to walk in the shade and keep up with the girl at the same time. She walked really fast. How far away was the food? She walked really very fast. How far away was the food? All these things, the girl was walking very fast, but the boy had to follow her without getting any way. After almost an hour of walking, they stopped in front of a big building. After walking for long an hour, they stopped in front of a big building. It was the name of the building was Sri Raja Rajeshwari Prasanna Kalyana Mandapam. The name of the building, they stopped at a large building, huge building. The name of the building was Raja Rajeshwari, Sri Raja Rajeshwari Prasanna Kalyana Mandapam. It was a red balloon, slowly a sign with the letters made of flowers, and that building had been decorated with the different flowers. Groom J.P. Vinayagan. The name of the groom was J.P. Vinayagan, bride Rani. Belu stared at the big cars parked outside. Perhaps in that huge building, which was named as Sri Raja Rajeshwari Prasanna Kalyana Mandapam, a marriage ceremony was going on. The name of the groom was J.P. Vinayagan. The name of the bride was Rani. So Belu stared at the big cars parked outside. One of the cars had a flower garland up and roses taped onto it. It was well decorated. The girl was very prompt, so the girl looked around and pulled one of the roses very quickly and stuck it in her hair. "Come on," she said. After doing so, then the girl asked the boy to come with him. "Are we going to eat here?" asked Belu, looking at the huge hall and the people inside. Thereafter, when the girl asked the boy to come with her, then Belu became very hopeful. Perhaps they are going to have some food there. Thank you. In the next class, we will discuss the rest part of the chapter.